Getting ready to sell your home in any market can be a long and tiresome process. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you the top three simplest tips to prepping your home for your new buyer. Hey everyone, I'm Katie Evans, owner and lead agent of the Living 48 Real Estate Team. So glad to have you back for another one of our weekly videos here. And today we're talking about the top three things that you can do to prepare your home to sell and find your perfect buyer. All right, so let's start at the top of the list. Third thing, repairs. You guys, I love this. We are coming out of a market where you had to consider this at all. In fact, now you're going to want to consider it just to get offers on your property. So I want you to actually walk through your property and look for things like broken doorknobs, burnt out light bulbs, all those kinds of things. I love this quote that we got from one of the articles that we were reading for this topic. And it says, "From a door that squeaks to a window that sticks, or a toilet that runs until you jiggle the handle." You guys know what that is. Jiggle the handle. "It's easy to ignore minor issues that seem like quirks. Buyers, however, may see these quirks as problems that lower the value of your home or as bargaining chips during the closing process." So instead of just living with what we've already lived with, seeing it as a quirky thing about our house, or it gives personality to the house, the buyer is going to actually be looking at those things and saying, okay, is there a bigger issue? Is there something else that they have not taken care of, deferred maintenance, those kind of things? So doing a walkthrough, taking note of those visible things, the things you know about, and getting them repaired before we take your house to market, that is tip number three. Tip number two, I want you guys to keep the buyer in mind. When you sell a house, you're no longer living in it, you're selling it. It's very, very different. So, general rule of thumb for when you're selling your house is to always keep the buyer in mind. You're going to do that by starting with a walkthrough of your house. We're going to start in the front of the house. I want you to look at the house from the street and be like, how does my front yard look? Is it clean? Do I have a nice entryway? What's a curb appeal look like? And then as we walk through the front door, what does that entryway look like? Is it inviting? Is it clean? Is it all of those kinds of things? So I want you to walk through your house and imagine that this is the first time that you're ever seeing it and that you're considering buying it. And I want you to make the changes that you need to really, really help the buyer fall in love with your house. Couple of other tips around this. Neutralize your spaces. Now, I'm not one that says you have to take every single family photo off the wall and all that kind of stuff. However, we do want to kind of neutralize the house a little bit. So consider taking like maybe a few of the photos down and cleaning off the refrigerator of all the photos and the kids' artwork and all that kind of stuff. Souvenirs that you've got, put those away. Religious symbols, put those away. Diplomas, certificates, hobby supplies, collections, DVDs, CDs, all those kind of cluttery items, go ahead and put those away. Okay. Although you may have years of memories and emotional attachments to your home, the buyer does not. And we want to remove those so that they can start making their own in that property as well. Also, keep it simple. If you're doing any touch-up painting, if you're doing any kind of redecorating, we want you to keep it clean and neutral. When the buyer walks into your house, we want them to see the house, not you who have lived in the house. Okay. All right. And tip number one, probably the most important tip ever in your entire life, is cleanliness is key. Okay. So not only are you wanting them to like your house when they walk into it, we also don't want them to get caught up in, oh my gosh, there's a dust bunny or anything like that. So a deep cleaning of your home, and touch up before every single showing is going to be super, super important, to not distract your potential buyer away from your home. All right. So aside from doing the mopping, the sweeping, those kind of things, decluttering, organizing, all that kind of stuff, I want you to consider these areas as well. Your countertops, your window sills, anything that is a horizontal surface, we want it wiped and cleaned. Then I want you to tackle behind closed doors, closets, drawers, cupboards. Like literally, there's nothing that's off limits when a buyer's looking to purchase your home. So I want you to think like the buyer. Open up the linen closet. Can you refold all the towels and make it look nicer? Okay. Also, go ahead and pack up all the stuff that you know you're not going to need to live for the next few months and store it in the garage. A garage is a garage is a garage. And if you have vacated the property during the showings, your car doesn't need to be in the garage, and we can use that as a staging ground for moving you. Okay, so don't worry about packing things up and don't worry about putting them in the garage for staging purposes. That is perfectly fine. And it gives you a head start on the packing process once you get that perfect offer in place. So, all right, as a wrap up for this quick video, just remember that when selling your house, it's like negotiating the best deal and finding your best perfect buyer. We want to make sure that we bring it all together. And that is going to happen with those three top tips: doing a few minor repairs before we ever take the house to market, keeping the buyer in mind as we're prepping the house for market, and cleanliness is key. Thanks, you guys, for watching this video. Of course, if we can help you, or if you have any questions or are considering selling your house, we would love to chat with you and be a resource for you. You can reach out to me directly at 480-415-1341, or of course, just message us on whatever platform you are consuming this content. You guys have a great one, and we'll catch you on our next video. Bye.